Hello, I'm Vicky Shikumbo, Executive Director of Creative Artists Cultural Exchange. On this edition, we're offering a cultural travelogue to the Kingdom of Morocco in North Africa.
Marrakesh. As eternal as the snows on the highest peak, as impressive as the Atlas Mountains, as steeped in history as the palm trees are rooted in the earth, Marrakesh stands as the finishing touch to a picture of timeless beauty. The mightiest kings fought for it. A line of dynasties inherited it. Sages, craftsmen, architects, painters, and sculptors of all ages built magnificent palaces, mosques, gardens, and Quranic schools. Marrakesh, the imperial city which, at the dawn of its history, gave Morocco its name. Principal city of the Almoravides. It gave its name to Morocco in the past and perpetuates its magic to this day. An oasis on the frontiers of the desert. A jewel at the foot of the Atlas Mountains. Marrakesh is the dazzling capital of southern Morocco. The Berbers and the Arabs come together here to mingle with the nomads and the mountain people. Every imaginable commodity around abounds. Craftsmanship flourishes, and there are palaces, hotels, restaurants, golf courses, and a casino. Marrakesh is the unchallenged capital of southern Morocco. The Koutoubia. Marrakesh awakens every morning with the same inflected intonation, the call of the Islamic muezzin going out from the 70-meter high Koutoubia, the spiritual beacon of Marrakesh. The Koutoubia minaret, visible from so far out over the plain, is the outstanding example of medieval architecture in the city. It was completed in the late 12th century. Jemaa Fena. On the northern side of the Koutoubia lies the main square of the Jemaa Fena, where the life of the city is at its most pulsating. The square provides a great open-air circus where from morning to evening, entertainers seek to amuse the crowds in from the countryside or living in the city. Storytellers always draw the largest circle of passionately attentive listeners. They act the parts they tell, aided often by background music of flute, tambourine, or drum. A similar accompaniment encourages the Ganawa dancers, who stress the beat with a kind of double-ended metal castanet and swirl the tassels on their cowry encrusted black caps. Snake charmers pull out their slithering charges from under the tambourines where they are trapped and encourage them to rear and sway to the sound of their flutes, or entwine themselves around their own necks or those of any hardy onlookers. All roads lead to Jemaa Fena Square. Musicians, dancers, healers, public scribes, storytellers, vendors of fresh orange juice or grill nuts, all coming together in a multicolored spectacle.
Hey, الخضر ديالو عقل علينا.
خليني نوريكم هذا دابا.
علاش؟
يعطيني واحد جوج دريمات فتوح.
على من؟
على اللي عمر بعيد عام فوق على شيخ الاسلام على موري عبد
القادر. على موري عبد القادر على زين الاولاد.
اجا ها يا سيدي.
اجا تعال.
العرق ديالي.
اجا شي.
لما نعاونك ساوت بلادي عرفت العرق ديال اليهود باش يتعرح.
اجا لا. عندك
شي حاجه.
محمد
والله علي ولا علي انا غادي نطلقها ونحبسوها قول اطلقها
كيما قال ادعي في الوريد
اطلقها
شي واش متقفه ولا انا اعتبرت ما تقنيتك ناقصه في القران
Carts overflowing with oranges and roasted grains women from the high atlas coming to sell their baskets musicians dancers public scribes with their black umbrellas, fortune tellers, portion vendors, healers and apothecaries all contribute to the unreal spectacle that in Marrakesh is commonplace. Then, as dusk approaches, the showmen make way for the hot food stalls, one after another, acetylene flames spring into life, and then in the starry night, the moon comes out to play the role it was destined for, to be the most magical of the thousand and one lanterns lighting up the Jemaa el-Fana Square. The air throbs with the rhythms of Arabia and of Africa. This is no show put on for the tourist. Although foreigners are eagerly greeted by the entertainers who hope for a bigger tip, the souk, the medina. North of the square runs the narrow, covered alleys of the souk. Here rows of little stalls sell the same goods as their neighbors. Henna, nuts and spices, clothing materials, gowns and jalabas, sandals and babouches, bags, belts, and leather goods of all kinds, pottery, baskets, and woodwork. So much is offered for the sale that one wonders it can ever find a buyer. Yet the lanes are packed with a moving stream of humanity, and it is strangely stimulating, that is for those who do not have claustrophobia, to drift along, part of this dense and continuous throng. You are in the souks. The souks are inside the Medina, the oldest part of Moroccan cities. Deep within the Medina, families still live. And it is within these sections where one can get the best bargains. Only Moroccan guides know how to reach the inner sanctum of the Medina. One or two corners of the souk deserve special mention. The little lane off to the right with the spice stalls leads into a small square where the stalls also sell dried up chameleons, dead owls, gazelle horns, and jackal's feet. These macabre articles can be ground up to make spells or used in traditional medicines. The dried up chameleons are used as antidote to snake bite. Occasionally, one can also find live chameleons in these stalls, for they are much in demand by housewives in summer as a rapid remedy against flies. Time has passed you by. In the copper soup, perhaps, where the metal is worked by craftsmen following age-old traditions, their faces set in profound concentration. Or perhaps it was the Lakhzal Souk, home of the wool merchants. or in the hubbub of the Zabia souk, where carpets and caftans are sold to the highest bidder. These attractive alleys of the carpet souk sell old and new carpets from the Atlas and beyond, and are stacked from floor to ceiling in the rows of little shops. Back on the other side of the main alley is another archway, which leads to a little square covered with the spreading branches of a huge old vine. Around the square are the stalls of antique dealers, where one may find old school boards with their beautifully written Quranic text, ornately carved wooden plaques which supported the camel litters of nomad women in the Sahara, and pieces of old painted furniture. Beyond this, the alley narrows, and hung across it are bamboo poles supporting skins of brightly colored wools and silks. For this is the dyer's souk, with its great metal vats and rainbow colors. You are in another world, where the smell of saffron, cumin, black pepper, ginger, cloves, and orange flower enchant the nostrils. Among sacks of almonds, ground nuts, and chickpeas, piled high like mountains, with baskets of dates, casks of olive, and pots of henna, flasks of rose extract, jasmine, mint, coal, pieces of amber and musk. In the Medina, the show never ceases, with the souks, a labyrinth of light and shade, branching off into an infinity of directions under the protective canopy of a trellis work of reeds. Moroccan festival of colors, sounds, and fragrances. To wander through the souks is to be drawn into a wonderful feast for the senses, and the pleasures become all the more intense when the object of the visit is the choice of a ring, a sword stick, a carpet, a pair of babouches, a woven basket, or rare sweet-smelling spices. To really enter into the spirit of the souk, you must be prepared to follow three essential rituals centered around the desire for something, bargaining for it, and finally acquiring it. Bargaining is an art which is practiced in good humor over a glass of mint tea, the national beverage of Morocco. A discussion over a price frequently turns into an amicable or even friendly conversation. There is a very strong tradition of high quality craft work in all the imperial cities. In Marrakesh, the leather work is of particularly high quality. You can see cobblers using the most traditional methods to sew their babouches. The region is also known for the incredible variety of its spices and for the quality of its Berber carpets. Nothing has changed in the souk's tanneries for many hundreds of years. Among the skins stretched out on the straw to dry in the sun, close to the vats,